do you want a potential high school recruit to see in your program and in your school?
Well, that's a loaded question. I think first and foremost, there's a lot of different avenues. So we want to reach out to them as early as we can with, basic questionnaire, just to say hello, to get the contact and get them up to see us in action just from a basketball, perspective. So what we've come to realize, it's super important to get that early initial contact and interest. And by young, I mean probably by their freshman, if not at the latest, their sophomore year. I will say recruiting, each individual has its own story. Unique story, I should say. Everyone owns their own story. There's no one way to recruit, but to really do a good job recruiting, you need to really, get your feelers out and get them interested earlier to start developing a relationship earlier. So what does that mean? All the different platforms you can. But we want to get them to campus and see us play in action and then show them our beautiful campus. So it's the chicken or the egg, because I think we have a lot to offer. But the interest that lies there with the younger ones are definitely the basketball aspect. That's the first thing that we want them to know, is start telling them our story, about the basketball program and how we've been able to build it.
And when you're looking at recruits, so do you take more of an eye test approach or what, highlight videos? What is preferred for you, if anything?
Wow. So definitely in the stands watching them play, at the most competitive environment that we can, usually typically during the summer, is a great evaluating period for us when we're in July and they're playing at the highest level at the exposure camps. So that's the biggest avenue. It's also where the NCAA allows us to go out and go from site to site. And there are our window, our biggest window of opportunities. So we'll go out for a week out on the road, and the staff will be out for really primarily a week straight. So that's our biggest big block of recruiting, to go out and cover and evaluate and see as many young ladies as we possibly can within those tournaments that we need to go out and cover. And then from there, start bringing them back on the campus. Another big recruiting tool for us that has paid off big dividends has been elite camps that we host. And we try, for us, really make it a good evaluating camp that they get to see. The NCAA allows us to have our staff work, our players around, and put them through a real day in the life of a Quinnipiac Bobcat. So what it does is it takes us off the sidelines of just evaluating them, and it allows us to coach them and build a really good relationship, and what it would be like to be here at Quinnipiac and find out really the in-depth of what we have to offer our student athletes. We like to give them, a peek behind the curtain and see put them through, a strength and conditioning process with Coach B, who our athletic trainer is, and Becky Mella. Meet our academic advisor and Casey Stark. Really, that performance team has been makes a huge difference in what we can offer a lot of other what a lot of other universities can't. So that makes a big difference, and that day is really important to our recruiting efforts.
And what would you say is the biggest obstacle you normally face when recruiting an athlete?
Obstacle. Well, it depends. Outside the region, that's Quinnipiac doesn't roll off the tongue, but we're kind of breaking that barrier down with our appearances in the postseason and our name flash up on the board. So that's typically been how do you say that school? It's just, it doesn't roll. So that's probably been the biggest challenge. But once we get a young lady to say yes to come visit us, I think it's always time well invested and spent that they never thought once they get here. I think like any student, that when they walk around and they say, we never expected Quinnipiac to be all this, and it surpasses anybody's expectation once they see the university and what it has to offer with all three campuses.
So would you say that maybe the campus itself is what sets Quinnipiac apart from other competitive mid-majors?
Well, I think there's a couple of things. I think in particular for us, we certainly like to really, we've carved out, I've said this a lot of times, we've carved out, I think, a really unique niche in terms of what we have to offer academically in a classroom setting where we're just under enrollment of 10,000 students, which isn't small and it's not large, but it gives that nice medium size feel to it. But the classroom, the attention in the classroom that our students get, the attention of the faculty, that you're not just gonna be a number, that you need to be in classroom attendance, participation, the relationship that they really do develop once they get into their majors, and then how the professors really take great pride in not only student athletes, but with their students and in seeing them succeed along the way, and really how they help them explore different avenues within their degrees, and really, you know, kind of, you know, what they should be doing, and guide them into not only communications, but what avenue of communications where they see a strength in you that you might not even see in yourself, I've seen firsthand. So I really like that aspect of the small classroom size, the attention you're gonna get, and not get lost in the shuffle. But when you come up to York Hill, that we have an incredible sports center that is dedicated solely to hockey and basketball. And then with this being basketball, for, you know, over just under 30 athletes, really just the crown jewel that this sports center has to offer, I would compete against anybody in the country. And it's just smartly built in terms of 3,500 people, and not trying to be something that it's not either with 10,000 or 15,000 seats. So I think we've carved out a really unique niche that this facility allows us to go out and compete with, you know, going up to Gamble Pavilion and the Power Five conferences. And then, but give usually those Power Five conferences, you're sitting in a seminar room, seminar class with like 150 to 200 people. And then we can offer really the best of both worlds academically and athletically.
What do you expect out of an athlete that has joined your program? What are your expectations for that student athlete?
To really be a great human. I mean, you know, we hold them to a really high standard of, you know, being a great student, being great in the community, wear the uniform proudly, because they're really representing more than just themselves, that they're representing a brand in Quinnipiac. And more importantly, they're in a fishbowl with Quinnipiac women's basketball with the success that we've been able to have on a national level. And so they really need to represent the very best in character and you know, giving, you know, an effort that's perfect, you know, almost perfect every time. So the standard here for quality, for character is pretty high. And, you know, understanding that, you know, there's a lot of pressures in that, you know, coming to college to become who you're supposed to become, and the challenges that everybody faces in those day to day. I think they get a lot of, support here from a great coaching staff that really cares about their well-being and helping them become their very best that they can become.
You touched on it with advisors and things like that a little bit, but in general, what type of systems or programs do you have in place for a student athlete that's having trouble off the court, whether that be with academics or personal life or things of that matter?
Well, I think that relationship with our student athletes certainly starts at a very young age while they're in high school. So I think it's a real trust outside of, you know, that relationship from family or coach in their high school that starts, you know, many years before they even arrive on campus. So that's already pretty strong. So there really is a sense of family when they arrive. So I think there's a good trust that's already established prior to them getting here and already knowing, you know, if they're having a good day or a tough day, to really kind of just say, hey, what's going on? Everything okay? So you know, I think that's been a strength of mine as a coach, to kind of read between the lines and seeing who needs a little pick me up and who needs a little, you know, a little nudge into, let's go, you have a little more to offer us today. But I think in general, the university does a really great job in identifying, you know, just, you know, different areas of all the students that have different needs, you know, with the different pressures that are going on and just in the world today. But academically, we have Casey Stark that allows us to really help in terms of, you know, practice times and scheduling and missed class times. You know, there's so much behind the scenes that if you don't have that performance team that allows them to, you know, get the classes, the class schedule, the practice times, the strength and conditioning, the nutrition part from your athletic trainer, it's not going to give them their best opportunity to perform out on the court to be their best basketball player, and then for us to become our best team. And I think that's what really separates Quinnipiac from a major part of all our competitors, and why we've been allowed to really grow and become a really good basketball program.
And lastly, and this one's a little general, so it's a little tricky, but if you were to give one piece of advice to a high school athlete that was deciding on where they wanted to go play in college, what would that be?
Go where they don't just like you, go where they love you. Go where they've been consistently showing you where you're going to fit, help, and their vision for you, and consistently have just loved you. Don't go where they like you, go where they love you.
That's all I have, Trish. Thank you so much for taking time out.
Thanks.
I really appreciate it.
Yeah.